The abbot's office is behind this door. Impossible. It's been locked with a key. I can see the library, the church, and the hospital from here. I can't reach it. Bruno, come here. And get down on all fours.
Master, what do you plan to do with me?
Don't contradict me. Be silent and obey. Aha! It could be that the abbot keeps something in there that could come in handy. It's a relief that capers like these aren't included in the stories told about the learned scholar Leonardo de Toledo. There are a number of interesting things inside. I don't see anything special. Tiny and quite lovely. Let's see what's inside. Snuff. I'll take a little. One pinch is enough. I don't want the abbot to notice it's missing. The hospital is well equipped. It's nothing more than a simple mortar.
What are you doing, Leonardo?
I'm taking the mortar with me, if you don't mind.
I don't mind much, but I'm very attached to it. And I'd prefer that if you have something to grind down, you do it here. If that's possible, then go ahead.
Oh, certainly. Fair enough. Good. It's inside. Fair enough. Inside we have Clotilde. A bit of snuff, a pinch of thyme. That's that. I'll toss the mixture into that crock. already full of water. I think it won't be necessary to get Bruno soaking wet today in order to get a little water. Inside we have a wilted leaf from Clotilde, a bit of snuff, a pinch of thyme. With an alembic, I can distill any kind of liquid. The outlet neck is broken. It would have to be fixed if I want to use it. That's a different story. Good. It's inside. Basic yet effective source of light. That's what it takes to make a good fire. I need something to get the fire going. If not, it's going to burn out soon and the charcoal won't light. Charcoal has caught fire. The distillation comes out here, drop by drop. We did it! And this is the result from distilling the ingredients of the formula.
What are you planning to do with the crock, Brother Leonardo?
Well, I... nothing really.
I've already told you. Wait till it's time for the meal.
Bruno, come here. Bruno, I'd like you to do something.
What? Again?
I need more soup, and you're going to help me get it.
But that's stealing.
There's no time for nitpicking. Get going.
Brother Martin.
Ah, it's you, boy. Have you come to pray?
Yes.
Don't think I wasn't aware that your master was going to take advantage of this to make off with a little soup. I'm not stupid. Don't worry. It's flattering that someone is going to so much trouble just to eat some of my soup. And besides, if I help a boy like you to recite psalms, so much the better. So, repeat after me. Cetaceans and fish, praise the Lord.
Cetaceans and fish, praise the Lord.
Cetaceans.
Cetaceans.
Bruno, stop pestering Martin. We have to go.
Yes, Master.
Goodbye, boy.
According to the Book of Prescriptions, whoever ingests its contents will fall into a deep sleep. Theoretically, of course. Let's hope that it works. He has the parchment we found yesterday in Anselmo's desk. I saw it with my own eyes. Brother Umberto, do you have a moment?
What do you want now?
My congratulations on that translation you did yesterday. Bruno passed the exam.
Is that right? Then I'm glad for him. That's what I heard.
You don't seem very concerned.
You don't either.
He wasn't my friend.
He wasn't mine either. Can I get on with my work?
How well did you know Gottfried?
Brother, be careful what you say.
What? What did I say? I believe that you have something that belonged to Gottfried.
Yes?
Yes, a parchment.
Brother, for God's sakes, enough!
There's a killer on the loose in the Abbey. Don't you fear for your life?
That's why you're here. So that it doesn't happen.
I cannot stand vigil over all the potential victims at one time. But perhaps I could prevent another murder if I stood vigil over one of them.
What?
Sooner or later, we'll talk about that matter.
Yes. Now is not a good time.
Ah, isn't it? Give me back the parchment, please.
What? Enough. I don't have a parchment. Do me a favor and don't pester me anymore with the matter.